Hey, it's Emilio here, and this video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity software for humans. Now, sometimes you've got yourself a hard drive that you just need to erase. Now, on the Mac, there's a few things. You've got hard drives inside of the Mac. You may have one, you may have two, depending on whether you've got a laptop or one of the desktop Macs. And of course, the Mac hard drive is probably going to contain the macOS operating system, maybe some other data. Then you've also got some external hard drives, USB drives that can be connected over USB or over USB-C. And they're connected into the Mac, and you need to use them for various reasons, and you also sometimes need to erase them. This video, we're talking about how to erase, how to format the best way, the proper way, a hard drive on a Mac, whether that be the internal hard drive on a Mac, whether that be a USB hard drive connected into your Mac. So how to format it, we're gonna talk about that in this video. Hey, before we do get into that, do remember to click on that subscription button and on the notification bell so that you don't miss out on anything. So go and grab your hard drive, grab your external disk, plug it into your USB ports, and let's now jump onto our Mac and we'll show you how to actually get everything up and running and erasing and formatting your drives.
So first things first is to go and open up your Finder and then navigate down to Applications, Utilities, and we're looking for Disk Utility. You can also go into the Spotlight search in the top right-hand corner of your Mac and search for Disk Utility in there. Once that is opened, your USB drive should now be detected. Let's have a look at what is being seen right over here. Down the bottom left here, we've got the externals. Now here I've got two external devices plugged in. One is a USB stick, one is a USB hard drive. Clicking on each of these, you can see exactly what that hard drive is about, the capacity, what it's formatted as. And in the top left-hand corner, this is my internal hard drive. So this is the hard drive that is inside of my Mac. Now, by default, your primary hard drive or your macOS is installed, you can't actually go and format that hard drive because formatting that hard drive would essentially erase all of the data that is on your Mac. And also, because you're booted into the macOS right now, you can't actually delete it because those files are being read, like they're busy. So the only way to do this is to actually shut down your Mac and start it up essentially into the system mode. And then within there, you can access Disk Utility to be able to then format that hard drive. However, that will erase all the content of your macOS installation and any data that is sitting on that hard drive. External hard drives, let's have a look. So here are the two devices that I've got plugged in. The first one is a Toshiba. You can see that it is a 16 gig, essentially just been calculated at 15.84. It's a USB external physical disk. Here is the partition map. And you can see that it's made up of one partition. You can tell that because it's just got one big blue line. If there was multiple partitions, you would see that accordingly. Now what we go and select is click on erase right over there. And now this is the part where we actually go and format the drive. You give the drive an appropriate name. My USB, for example, and then the format that you want to actually format this to. You'll notice that on the macOS, there are different formats available. You're firstly going to get the APFS, which is Apple's file system. This is a format that's only going to be read and readable on a Mac. So if you're going to format this external hard drive, it will not work on a Windows computer. So just be aware of that. The other one is macOS Extended. Similar to APFS, it's only going to be read and readable on a Mac. Now, this is a newer technology, the APFS. This is the older technology called macOS Extended. So if for whatever reason you are plugging in a USB hard drive to a very, very old Mac, then it won't actually read APFS either. If you do want to use it across other platforms, then you can format it as exFAT, EXFAT, or MS-DOS-FAT. And those two formats are going to be available and readable on a Windows computer. Now, one other thing that you want to be aware of is on Windows computers, there's another format that we can't see right over here called NTFS. And that is a format that is a Microsoft format that will only work on a Windows computer. So if you grab a USB stick, a USB drive that has been formatted on a Windows computer using the NTFS format, you'll be able to read the contents on the Mac. However, you won't be able to edit, you won't be able to delete, you won't be able to add anything new into that USB hard drive because it is formatted only for Windows. So I would recommend if you are intending to use this hard drive across platforms, format it in EXFAT or MS-DOS FAT. Now the newer version and the one that I'd recommend is EXFAT. That's gonna allow you to have much bigger files added into that partition and into that drive. Okay, so we can select whichever format we want. The scheme is gonna ask you what sort of partition table you want to use. So only use that and change that if you know what you need to do. Otherwise, just leave it as the default. Some other options available too around security, and you'll notice that down the bottom, it lets you know what that particular security option will actually do. Once you're happy with what is happening right over here, we click on erase. That hard drive is now currently being erased, it's been unmounted, and it's now been formatted using the format that we have selected. And if you've now got a nice big green tick, it means that it has been successful. Click on done, and it's ready to go. You'll now see it's got the new information around your USB hard drive and the various partitions right over there. If you do want to create various partitions, essentially little chunks of space within your USB drive, you can click on partition area over here and actually set different partitions, formatting them to different things. So what will happen is if you grab a USB stick, a hard drive, plug it into your computer, it will actually show up as potentially three individual hard drives if there are three partitions. One physical disk, but multiple partitions, software-based partitions within it.
Hey, let us know down below in the comments what you thought, and do as always, remember to click on that subscription button on the bell so that you don't miss out on anything. And we'll see you on the next video.